the spider's web, and in this video we're going to get this character looking more like that. So stay tuned and let's get cracking. So what do we want first off? Well, paint is usually a good place to start. So for the skin tone we're going to be using Bugman's Glow. For the skulls, the bones and everything, we're going to be using White Scar and Screaming Skull. And for the hair, we're going to be using Abaddon Black. And for the handle of the axe type thing he's holding, we're going to be using Dryad Bark. So, let's get on with it, shall we? First off, Bugman's Glow. That's the skin tone we're going to be using, so it gives a nice dark brownish skin tone. So let's get on with it, shall we? And I knew I'd done something wrong before. Just as I put the paint on the palette, I realised I hadn't actually dried the palette off. So this is going to be one of those videos, I think, where I'm going to be doing everything wrong. Ah well, never mind. So, starting off with a nice clean number 2 brush. I'm just hoping it's a clean one. And I'm getting some water on our palette, on our brush rather, not that we need it because there's a lot on the palette already. And so get it on our brush and then we'll go over all of the skin tone. Now we did do this, and then after all the paint has dried, we will be going over with Agrax Earthshade to cover everywhere in. I'm not fussed about going over the necklaces here, as you can see, because we'll be going over them afterwards, so there's no need to be bothered about them. These are nice models. I've enjoyed painting these ones at the club. I've had two hour sessions I've done to get the minis to the state that they're in already. I'm saying 2 hour sessions, they're not quite 2 hour sessions. Because we do stop partway for a cup of tea, and there's always people wanting to talk. So it's not sort of like 2 hours solid, but the air group meets for 2 hours. In that time, I think I'm about lucky to get an hour and a half painted. But hey, doesn't matter. It's all part of it. Get together, you paint. Usually paint pictures, but every now and again I get a bit of a block, or I want to get some minis done quickly, so I take these in and get them painted. It does help. Plus it gives a talking point for everybody else, because they seem amazed that I'm actually taking these in and painting them. They all seem surprised that I take these in to paint them, even though they're they show surprise at what I'm painting, even though they've seen me painting this type of thing before. They always seem to get the, oh, they're fiddly. Yep. It allows me to get them done. And I don't see much point in trying to save everything for camera, because you don't really want to see me painting. How many of them are these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There's 15 of these so far. And they're all the same pose. Basically the same model. And I don't see why you'd want to see me painting the same model over and over and over and over again, when once will be enough. It's just going to get to be a boring series if I painted all of the minis I've got. So these troop ones, or these multiples of the same minis that I've got, I'll paint off camera, but I'll always leave one to paint on camera so you can see how I did it. That's a skin tone done. I told you it was easy. I think I have forgotten a colour that I used. I think I used this for the loincloth type thing. Steel Legion Drab. I've used that for the loincloth, so I will continue to do so. The other thing is, this isn't dry enough yet to do the loincloth, so what I will do first off is the bone in his hair. In fact, no, I won't. I'll do his hair first, which is, as I say, Abaddon Black for the hair. A little into the palette, and I put way more than I need. Oh well, not to worry. And I'm going to try and get as close to the skin as possible with this. Now I'm going to paint quite a lot of this as her. I will be going back and picking out one or two bits in white, because there is a bone through his hair, or two bones through his hair, as you can see. And it's a little tricky trying to work out where it actually comes out from until you actually see it painted. It always strikes me as odd, you can't see things until painted, and then you can see where things are or what things are. But there we are. Oops. I do believe I'm going to try to do some tattoos on these fellas, or some body painted kind of thing, later on, so stay tuned on that one. What did I use for that? Okay. Next, I'm going to be using the white. In fact, no, I'm not going to use the Steel Legion Drab. I'll save the white for last. Steel Legion Drab can go on now. Again, don't want much. That should be enough. At least I think it's this colour I used. I can't remember now. Oh well. Yeah, I think it was. You see, it's going on quite thinly. It's building up in the recesses. I don't want it going on incredibly thick. Yeah, put me way more than I need out, but never mind. Not important. So there we have. Now, we'll change over paints to the skull, or screaming skull, rather, which again is this one. We'll pop some of that onto our palette. Again, we don't want much. I probably put out way too much there, but still. Again, never mind. Better putting out too much than not enough. And these are going to be done now. Well, this is going to be used rather for these skulls here. Oh yeah, and also say for the want of a better word, the axe head. Doesn't matter if I go over the actual axe handle itself, because there's going to be a darker colour over it anyway, so it will get covered up. Want to make sure we cover the wrappings on it, on the handle. So actually wrappings around the area here. Then I think, no I didn't, I thought I might have done the I thought I might have done that skull there in this colour. I didn't, it's in white. You can tell with the difference in shade. So I'm not going to put the white on the palette because there's not much of it I'm be using. I'm just making sure the brush is damp-ish. I'll just take some out of the pot and put some on these bones here. And this bone as well. I'm not forgetting the strip there, and also around here. Just like so. And there is your Pict Warrior. Almost done. I just need to do the handle. Which is in the dryad bark. Again, I'm not going to bother with the palette for this, because there's not much of it that needs doing. So I'm just going to pop some off straight from the pot. Just like so. Make sure though that you always make sure that you've not got it all building up somewhere. Make sure you get a nice even coverage of this if you're taking it from the pot like I am now. That will be it. There you go. I need to just go back into the screaming skull for 1 second, because I've gone over this part here. I'm just going to touch up the back of these skulls as well. Right. I just need to leave it for a few moments. Now, as I said, what I did was I got my brush and I gave it a going over with Agrax Earthshade, and I mean all over. It's a very simple process. There's no faffing about at all with any of this. Just put it on. One thing you do want to do is try and make sure you don't put too much on. Any areas where you do feel as though you put too much on, you can always spread it out. Yeah, because if you do put too much on, what's going to happen is it's going to pool up around his feet. And I think I have used a wrong colour, or a different colour, somewhere along the line, but doesn't matter. I got the basics done the exact same way as I did the others. I still think I did the loincloth in that colour. I may be wrong. I'll just have to look at them once again when this has dried to check, but it doesn't look quite right to me at the moment. But that's it so far. See how it looks. There we are. We'll get a better idea of how it looks once it's dried, but for now that's all we can do. So from me and my little Pictish friends here. You can see what I mean about him pooing up around his feet. If that happens, then all you need to do is take a damp brush and just go around the very edges, and that way you won't get that pooling there. So just keep an eye on it as it's drying. But you shouldn't have any problem with it. But that's it for this video. I hope you enjoy it. When we come back, we'll get this highlighted, and then I can make a start on highlighting the others as well. So all I need to do is that one and another 14, and jobs are done. So until next time, as always, take care, God bless, and bye.